Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create this sleek, shiny pill from scratch. This is an update of a tutorial I did on an earlier version of Photoshop. Create a new document by going to File and New. For this example, make its width 1550 pixels, its height 870 pixels, and its resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB at 8 bits per channel. Then click OK. Go to View and make sure Rulers and Snap are checked. If they aren't, just click on them. Go to the ruler at the top and drag out a guideline to the center of your document. It'll snap in place because we have Snap checked. If you don't see it, press Ctrl or Command H. Go to the ruler on the left and drag out another guideline to the center. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. In this layer, we'll make the shape of the pill. Open your Rounded Rectangle tool. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Click Pixels. If your version is CS5 or earlier, the pixel icon is here. For its radius, type in 200 pixels. Click the gear icon and tick Unconstrained and check From Center. Go to the center of your guidelines and drag out your pill shape. Double-click on an empty area of the pill's layer to open its layer style window. Click Gradient Overlay. The style is linear and the angle is 90 degrees. Click the gradient bar. Click the lower right stop and the color box. For its brightness, type in 50%, then click OK or press Enter or Return for both windows. Click Stroke and the color box. For the brightness, type in 50%, then close the window. Make the size 8 pixels. The position is outside and the blend mode is normal. Click Inner Glow. Make the blend mode normal, the opacity 40%, and the size 35 pixels. Then click OK. Next, we'll add text onto the pill. Open your horizontal type tool and press X on your keyboard to invert your foreground and background colors. For my font, I'll use Arial Black, however, you can use whatever you like. I'll make its size 125 points, smooth, and center text. Click on your document and type your text. To center it over your pill, click your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A. Click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. Next, we'll warp the text to simulate wrapping around the contour of the pill. To do this, press T to open your Type tool and click the Warp Text icon. Click Bulge and tick Vertical. Play with the bend percentage until your text is approximating the perspective distortion that it would have. Generally, the longer your text is, the higher the bend percentage should be. For this example, I typed in a bend of 20%, then click OK. Change its blend mode to overlay. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. In this layer, we'll create the highlight on the pill. Open your Rounded Rectangle tool. Click the gear icon and uncheck From Center. Place your cursor at the top point where your pill is starting to curve around and drag your tool across, approximating the shape. To center it over the top of your pill, press V on your keyboard to open your Move tool, press Ctrl or Command A, and click the Align Horizontal Centers icon. Then deselect it. Let's rename the layer Highlight. Double-click on the thumbnail to open its Layer Style window. Check Blend Interior Effects as Group. Activating this advanced blending option will give us the effect we want. Later, I'll show you what the highlight would look like if we didn't check this option. Click Gradient Overlay and the Gradient Bar. Click the lower left stop and the color box. For brightness, type in 25%. Then, close all the windows. Change the blend mode to screen and reduce its opacity to 90%. Let's see what the highlight would look like if we didn't check the Blend Interior Effects as Group feature. As I toggle back and forth, you can see the difference. Next, we'll split the pill into two halves and make the right half a bit smaller. Scroll to the bottom of the Layers panel and hide the background layer. Scroll back up and make a composite snapshot of your pill by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Alt-click or Option-click on the eyeball next to the composite snapshot to hide all the other layers. To save space in the Layers panel, let's group all the source elements that comprise your pill into its own folder. To do this, make the highlight layer active and shift-click on the black shape of your pill to highlight all the elements. Then, press Ctrl or Command G. Let's name the folder Elements and hide it. Make the white background visible. Make the pill layer active and Ctrl-click or Command-click on the thumbnail to make a selection of its shape. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool. Press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag a selection over the left half of your pill, snapping it to the vertical guideline. Now, we have a selection of just the left half of your pill. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy the left half of your pill onto its own layer. Make the full pill active, and again, Ctrl-click or Command-click on it to make a selection of its shape. As before, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag a selection over the right half of your pill, which makes a selection of just the right half. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy it onto its own layer. Now that we have the two halves of the pill, we can trash the composite snapshot. We don't need to see the guidelines anymore, so let's hide them by pressing Ctrl or Command H. We're going to make the right half of the pill a bit smaller. To do this, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. At the top, you'll see percentages for the width and the height. If we click on the chain link, whatever we type in one will be copied into the other. Go to either the width or the height and type in 99%. Notice they're both the same because the chain link is active. Press Enter or Return to accept the transform. To move the right half of the pill to the left half, press V to open your Move tool and press the left arrow on your keyboard until the gap disappears. Next, we'll create the shadow. Ctrl-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of the right half to make a selection of its shape. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool. Press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over the right half of your pill just a little to the right of the other selection. Then, Release your cursor. You should now see just a sliver of the selection. The shadow will be inside this area. Open Levels by pressing Ctrl or Command L. For the input midtones, type in 0.65 and close the window. Then deselect it. Next, we'll add the reflection. First, let's merge the two halves into one layer. To do this, shift-click on the top layer to highlight it and press Ctrl or Command E. Make a copy of it and make the lower pill active. Reduce its opacity to 50%. Go to Edit, Transform, and Flip Vertical. Press V to open your Move tool, and press and hold Shift as you drag the reflection below the solid pill. We need to close the gap between the shadow and the pill only on the left half. To move the reflection up one pixel at a time, press the up arrow key on your keyboard. There should remain a gap on the right half between the pill and its reflection. Next, we'll make the reflection gradually fade into the background. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the shadow. Open your gradient tool. Make sure the linear gradient icon is highlighted and the gradient bar is black to white. Place your cursor a little below halfway down the shadow and press and hold Shift as you drag up the gradient line to the bottom of the pill, then release. Lastly, I'll show you how to quickly give it color. Make the top layer active and click the adjustment layer icon. Click Hue Saturation. Check Colorize and slide the saturation a bit to the right to intensify the color. Then, slide the hue to a color you like. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching!